Welcome to Extensive Ideas Academy. Our today's lesson is Google AdWords. We'll see how you can plan your advertisement in Google search, the partner search engines and other partner sites of Google using Google AdWords. Google AdWords is very easy to use, and following the steps that I'll give you, you can easily plan your advertisement. There is also a Google Help and Support Center always available with toll-free number for different countries. You can reach out to them for further assistance, or you can reach out to us. We will help you in planning your advertisement, setting up your advertisement and creating an ad that brings more results for your company. The ads that you plan for your Google advertisement are generally focused on your product, service or website. Even contents can also be taken for advertisement using Google's other partnering sites. Display, text, video, these type of different medium are used to take your advertisement to the customers. Even AdWords help you in planning your advertisement for YouTube as well. In YouTube, whatever advertisement you see are all planned through AdWords. Now let's start with the lesson. First we'll see keyword research. Keyword research is the very basic and most important component for any advertisement. It helps you get a wider idea, a wider thought and more number of keywords to plan your advertisement in a better way. You can phase your keyword research based on long tail, generic keyword, local search, city specific search or national search. Also, you can take a lead by following your competitors' keyword and advertisement or ad text that you can get by using few premium tools that we will talk about in the coming lessons. But currently we will see the same in only Google AdWords keyword planner. Competitors' keyword and the ad text or ad they are giving. For doing that, you can use different paid tools like Ahrefs or Spyfu. They provide you with a way to see your competitors' keyword, ad text and the cities or the places they are targeting. If you are using display advertisement that you can use through your Google partner sites or even for YouTube ads, display ads always need to show the best of your product so people get attracted to your website and buy your product more often. If there is no such best product available with your company, you can give the look of a best product to any of your product so they look attractive for the buyers. When starting Google AdWords, every time for every account you get a free ad credit from Google. This is a one-time free ad credit that you get, and the cost or the price may differ from country to country. It is available while only starting your account, and the account manager from Google generally adds or allocate the same with your account, or even you may get a voucher code to be applied inside your AdWords account. One single group should not carry more than 10 keywords, but there is no limitation that you can keep 10 keywords. You can keep n number of keywords in a group. But generally, when you look for advertisement, the products, the services or the offer that you sell, they need to go to the different buyers with a different ad text, different ad presentation. Keeping that in mind, you should keep less number of keywords in a single group and create multiple group with multiple keyword set targeting different segment of people, different segment of geographical area or other criteria to get more productive AdWords campaign. You can also follow keyword effectiveness index. These keyword effectiveness index is not generally available with the AdWords keyword research tool. For this you can use many other keyword research tool where it is available. It also helps you in understanding which keywords are getting more result. If you are countering a lot of fake click problem, then local advertisement using the local map is very helpful. In maps, it is little bit difficult to create the fake clicks. So using that, you can get more leads that is based on local map and avoid the problem of fake click that you're facing in your normal AdWords campaign. Businesses with many offices across many cities can also use the local advertisement that is based on Google Maps. It helps them to get the local share of the customer and attract many people towards your business who are not till now coming to your business. As you can see, the map-based result and the people who search in the map or get the map result for their requirement is a little bit different. So plan for the keyword, or let Google plan for your keyword in a way that is not applicable for normal search campaign. When you are planning any ad focusing the mobile devices, the call only ad where the mobile number comes in the screen and help the mobile users just click on it and give a call to the business is very helpful. These type of call only ads are not applicable for desktop, they are generally applicable for mobile devices. But you can use the ad extension to keep a number in your desktop based advertisement that we will talk about later. Mobile ads are getting more and more attraction these days because mobile based users are increasing. Currently more than 60% users who use Google are from mobile devices. So planning for mobile devices will give you more result and better conversion. Do try the call only ad and plan for them properly with creating different group for mobile devices. It's not like for a general group you can create a mobile based call only ad. Create separate group, separate ad text, focus the device that you are targeting and then set the ad. Ad script, keyword, landing page, the product, device and PC all becomes a factor while planning the advertisement and planning for the keywords. Keep them separate with different groups and create different landing pages for different advertisement. You will also need to watch for your quality score while working with these factors. Also focus on your budget and long-term advertisement because that also boosts your quality score. A/B testing. It is a vital part of any advertisement campaign for any platform, and for Google also it applies. If you don't have a A/B testing plan, keeping different group, different keyword, different ad page, different landing page and the different product segment, and keep changing among them with a variation ratio, you will not be able to get the proper or targeted crowd to buy your product. You will not be able to get the buyers as you want for your products. Now when you plan for your advertisement, almost 98% people leave the advertisement and only 2% people buy your product or take your service. So this means 98% people who have visited your page or advertisement have connected with your company, business or product. Now to get these people or target only these people, you need a remarketing campaign. Set a remarketing campaign so these left out people can be again targeted and more amount of conversion can be achieved from these advertisements. In the analytics account, as you see, we have to go to the tracking info and from there activate the remarketing if it is not active currently or turn it on. Now once you turn it on, there will be a requirement of keeping a privacy policy that you are tracking the traffic for remarketing in your website. You can generate a privacy policy from this website. It is quite simple. As you can see, there are a lot of steps given and accordingly you can provide the details and the website will generate a general privacy policy. Provide the country, website name, the location, the place, the URL. The This is just a name. Here you can select whichever you want according to your requirement, which data you are capturing. If you are sending email, so you can select this one. The unsubscribe option, if you are using any MailChimp or Aweber kind of mailer, you can select the unsubscribe, or you can select the contact directly by email. If you are tracking location information, then you can select it or just leave it. So here you can see what are the analytics platform you are using. Google Analytics, as we are currently preparing. Here you will have to provide the email address using which users can contact you. You can either take a professional privacy policy or a free privacy policy. Free one will be the standard text, just replacing your data, and professional one will have a copy free privacy policy, custom made with some payment. Now you can copy it and place it in your website as a page and highlight the same somewhere inside your website like this. Once you have done this, creating the audience becomes the next step. Connect the account first. Once it is done, let's go to the AdWords account and create a campaign for remarketing. Here you will see different options where the tracking information from your website or other data source would be available. The name of the campaign, this is the average daily budget that you would like to spend. If you keep an accelerated mode of delivery, then your budget will run out faster. So I suggest keep it standard. You can always do A/B testing, which one is getting more result and what is your budget is also very important. Now here, click on the edit target audiences. Here you can get the targeted audience that you want to capture. This would be the by the interest or habit, or what people are searching currently, or people who have interacted with us or with your business. We have selected the last one. We want to target those people who want to connect, who have connected with us. If you have any AdWords list that you can connect over here, this is the preference of people, the category of people that you want to target. Whatever suits you the best, you can select. Now come to the cost per click. Here I would like to keep the no automated targeting, as we have selected some manual settings, so keep the manual one. Now cost per click should be the one that is an average cost that all your keywords are providing. This is the website ID. Now create the ad. You can create a text ad or a display ad. Your campaign, which is focusing with different cities and the country as a whole, should be kept separate. How you can keep them separate? You can create different ad text, different ad group, and create a different keyword list in those groups and name them with the cities and the country as a whole. Even for country, you can create different groups with different product. In this way, your advertisement will bring best revenue because they are focusing the niche segment, and getting people attracted becomes easy when you focus the niche segment. Now, it is not possible that people will look at your advertisement at any time of the day. So for this, you need to schedule the advertisement. Scheduling the advertisement is quite possible. In the AdWords account, you can set the time duration of the day when you want your ad to reflect in search or other partner site or partner search engines. In that way, you not only get more targeted people towards your advertisement, but also you help your business increase revenue by getting the best people to buy your product. Now, broad match, phrase match, and exact match are the three categories of keyword that you will see while planning the keywords. For these three, these are the different ways you can do the search to get the best keyword search result. Long tail and short tail or generic terms. The long tail terms are generally terms which is like bread and butter company in Kolkata, a bread and butter company of Delhi. The generic term would be bread and butter companies. Food stores would only be food stores. Shoe store. These are the generic term where extra amount of keyword is not added to the basic term. When you add something to the basic term like food store of Kolkata, food store of Delhi, food store of New York, it becomes a long tail keyword. So with these type of keywords, you can target different group of people. So keep long tail and short tail keywords separate. Ad extensions. There are a lot of ad extensions that you can use to get more productive result from your advertisement. These are the ad extensions. See how you can use the ad extensions to add phone number or other data in your advertisement. Now, while planning for the advertisement, you should have a budget in mind. Keep your advertisement campaign for a longer duration. Then only you will get result. So the budgeting should be on a long term basis, and short term budgeting should be avoided. Partner sites are the places where you can do the banner advertisement, and these help you build your brand and get the product highlighted to the user directly. Dynamic advertisement, they help get your pages from website automatically in the ad campaigns and fetch the product automatically to help you reduce on the time you are spending on AdWords campaign and get the product to the people who actually need it. Dynamic ad campaigns are very helpful for e-commerce website. Let's plan the ad. First, we will go to the keyword planner. Here we will type the keywords. These are all generic terms. If you are planning an ad based on the generic terms, then you can go for the keywords that you see. You can see Google have found 1575 keywords, but I have already spoken that you cannot keep all those keywords in a single group, so maximum number of keywords you should keep in a single group is 10. So let's select 10 and create an ad. And in the same way, you can gradually create all the ads by finding your focus keyword of generic or long tail keywords. Now here you can see broad match, phrase match, exact match. I provide you the key terms that you can use while finding for the broad or exact match. Now let's have a group name. It's a test group, or you can keep a flower, generic. So now we have a group. If you want to remove any negative keyword, so you can do that by searching the keywords again and placing them in the negative keyword segment. Currently we are not doing it, but you can definitely do it, and you must do it to avoid any wrong charging. Then the group is created, so add to plan. These are now added to plan. Let's see the plan overview. So this is the probable situation, what might happen, what kind of costing that can come. So if you are targeting focus can be anything. Okay. So once you have the budget ready, move to the ad group. So this is the ad group where we have added all the keywords. Okay, now let's create the campaign. Put a campaign name. You can keep more number of groups under a single campaign. There is no problem in that. This is the recommended budget for this type of a planning, or you can put any, you know, daily custom budget, like suppose 1500 or maybe 5000 rupees. Okay. Save it.
So the campaign is now ready. Let's go back to the campaign. This is the campaign. There is a group under the campaign, and these are the keywords with the average CPC of 46 rupees. So you can manually now change the CPC rate. To change it, you can even check them. Here you can see the top of the page bid rate is 39 rupees, but it is coming 46. You can now reduce it to 39. In that way, you can check the florist is coming 52. So you can have for florist, you can keep it. For flower bouquet, it is 29 rupees. See how much less it is. And remember, this is the top of page bid, and this is the top of page bid low range and the high range. And even for this also, you can come on the lower. This is the top of range, this is the lower. Now once we are done with the campaign formation, what we need a ad to start with. Let's go to the add an extension. We've already spoken about the extensions, which can be these. You can add a site link call out extension, structured snippet call extension, message where you can interact, location, price, and all this thing. Considering you know what type of extension you want to add, let's create an ad. Text ad or call only ad. Call only ads are for only mobile. Here you can track the ad. So we are not talking about the tracking part here. So we have created an ad that you can see over here, and let's now save it. So the ad is saved. So once the ad gets verified, it will come over here. Here the ad comes under review. Once it gets reviewed, you will be able to run the ad. Let's keep it in a paused condition. On a generic targeted keyword group, now you can follow the same technique to prepare the ad for other keywords and other groups. If you need any help, support, advice on Google AdWords, please call.